Hi everyone. Today let's learn about Snowflake's another important feature, time travel. Snowflake already has very little administration. You do not need to do typical DBA tasks such as indexing tables, partitioning, or dealing with the space-related issues. Time travel is another feature that lets developers self-serve DBA-related tasks of reverting, restoring, and managing the database. In this video, we will see some more details about time travel and its relevance. We will also see a demo of all time travel-related commands and parameters that affect it. And finally, we will have some notes related to time travel. Snowflake's time travel enables accessing historical data, be it changed data or deleted data, at any point within the defined time period. We'll come back to that defined time period. It is a powerful tool for restoring the data-related objects such as schema, tables, or databases that may have been accidentally deleted or intentionally deleted. It is also helpful in duplicating and backing up data from key points in the past. So you will be able to restore the database, say, as of 3 hours prior to current date. Or it could be analyzing data usage and manipulation over specified time period. For example, you might be interested to pull all the records as of 4 hours before. Let's take a look at Snowflake's data lifecycle and where is time travel applicable. So this is on Snowflake's documentation page. So we have a normal create table, create database, schema, and tables, and then we insert the data into those, and then we have querying data. So querying is where we can apply the time travel. As you see, the ones that are marked with the red, those are the ones where we have time travel applicable. So while querying the data, you can say, show me the list of records as of 2 hours earlier, or as of one of the particular query before one of the query was executed. You can use the query ID there. So we'll see some examples of that. So similarly, you can also use it on create schema, create database. And once you drop a table, you can undrop a table with the undrop command. And similarly, we have undrop schema and undrop database. This time travel has limited time period in which you can recover the data. For standard accounts, it is 1 day, and for enterprise accounts, it is up to 90 days, and you will be able to change this with a parameter within the range that you are allowed to. Let's head straight into a demo. Data retention time in days is the parameter that we were talking about that determines whether we are going to retain the old version of deleted or updated data, and if so, for how many days. So let's take a quick look at this parameter. So I can see that set up for the whole account, or I can also set it up differently per databases. It mostly makes sense in case of enterprise edition. And in standard edition, it's just 1 day. So either you can disable it or enable it. So I can also see all the parameters set for my account, in which data retention time in days is one of them. So I can also filter the records with wildcard characters like this. And then I can change a parameter by saying alter database, the database name, set the parameter equal to the number or the value. So similarly, I can also set it up for the whole account, and that will apply to all the underlying databases if I have not explicitly changed per database. All right, let's take a quick look at this patients table. I have four records in this. Now, to begin with, I will make a change to add the fifth record called test patient. Add it. So now when I look at patients table, I have the fifth record. If I look back at the patients table as of 1 minute before, I will see only four records. If I run patients, I have five, whereas 1 minute before, I did not have all five records. So this is the syntax wherein you are mentioning offset where you are, where it's the number of minutes here, minus 1 minute. Now I can also go ahead and delete this record and then drop the table, and then I will also be able to get them back. So let's delete the table, drop the table. If I try to select, it will not be there. Now I can say there should be one undrop command here. Yeah, table patients. So that is restored, and I should be able to now look at that patients table. It's back. Okay. It's been a minute or two. Let me try. If I run the same query of 1 minute prior, I should still be getting the same. Whereas if I say 5 minutes before, yeah, I have four records. So you can use this logic to change number of minutes, or you can also multiply it by 60 to make it hours. And so let's look at some more details. If it is over a day, mine is a standard account, so it does not let me use the time travel beyond a day. So if you want to look at the data as of a particular time frame, so you can use this. Although I have used a wrong date here, 2015, that's why it's not letting me, but this is the format. If I use the today's date, let's say Saturday, it is 16th, and this is March 2019, and this is 4:20. Yeah, it should work. See, that's it already had four records as of 4:20 this afternoon. So this is the syntax to use it. Use the timestamp to look back at data as of certain time. You can also use the same syntax for undoing and things like that. So let's look at another example here. So we have something called before. So this is the one which uses the query ID. So what you see here is a long string, right? This is a query ID. I have been running the queries. So every time I run, I see a query ID here. If you click on this, you get the query ID. Now, how do you get the query IDs that I had generated, let's say an hour ago? You want to know the data prior to that. Generally, you will have a certain statement. You will be knowing that, okay, I run that update statement. After that, all the data got messed up. Or I ran this delete statement. After that, everything got screwed up. But then you may or may not remember the precise time to revert the data with this command. So what I can do is I can go to history that shows me all the queries that were recently executed. So I can pick one of them. For example, let's say I'll pick any insert statement or undrop. Okay, here is one. So before this, what was my data? So let's say I want to look at that. I will use this query ID. I can copy the query ID from here, come back to worksheets, use it here. and say give me the user access data before that, or I can use the same on patients too. Okay, so it will give me the data as it was before running this query. This is quite handy sometime. And then similarly, I can recreate a table from a deleted table or as of certain time. So here in this case, at this point of time, whatever was the table data of user access, I'm using that to create a new table. So in other words, the data as of this time frame from an existing table is recreated in another table. Similarly, I can also use the offset to say that create this user access table as it was, let's say 10 minutes ago. So let's run this. I already have a object with the same name, so let me refresh and drop that restored table. Here is a command, I'll drop it. So 10 minutes before, this is how my table was. I can run a select star from that table. Okay. And similarly, I can also restore a schema as of say an hour ago. Or I can also restore the whole database before certain statement, because I may be knowing that, okay, after that statement, a lot of updates happened and do not want any of those. So in which case, let's say you just want to try if that is the correct data, then you can go back and restore the data as of that statement, before that statement, and get all that data into this restored DB. Let me try this. Processing aborted due to error. Probably this was an old ID. Let me paste the recent one that I used. It should create. There you have it. So we should have a new restored DB. Here it is. And finally, we have undrop table that restores the table if it is deleted, undrop schema, and undrop database. These are quick and simple ways to restore them if they were accidentally deleted. So with this, we have covered most of the time travel related details. So time travel is available only for 1 day for normal accounts and about 90 days, up to 90 days on enterprise accounts. But Snowflake's support team can go for another 7 days in addition to that 1 day limit that we have for time travel. But you need to go through Snowflake Computing's support team for that. So that's a wrap for time travel video. I hope you had something to learn out of this video. Let me know if you have any technical challenges in Snowflake. I'll be glad to answer them. I hope this video was useful for you to learn about time travel. If it was, please do like and subscribe to the channel and share it with your friends. Thank you.